worship and honor I give to you, Lord. You've been so wonderful.
We have two dynamite speakers on today that you don't have all day. First, we're going to bring on Benjamin Stone. And after her, Crockett Young is going to come over and take over from there. Give all hand praise that God comes forth.
We thank God we are here to help him celebrate 39 years.
1 Corinthians and the 9th chapter and the 24th verse. I want you to read 9th chapter of 1 Corinthians and the 24th verse, okay?
First Corinthians, the 9th chapter, verse 24. Know ye not that they which run a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? So run that ye may obtain.
Praise be to God.
Amen. For I am now ready to be offered, and the time of my departure is at hand.
Read it seven.
I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith.
Okay.
Praise the Lord. Can you hear me now?
And I began to think about the apostle. And some may don't know.
He didn't always think, may the Lord have a blessing of reading of his word.
All right.
He was not always an apostle. I remember when he first came to this church along with the lady. She wasn't First Lady Blige, but she was Gail Dixon.
All right.
And she invited him to come to church. And he came. The choir at the time had to go out. Amen. And he had a car. We need a ride. We didn't have enough ride. So we thank God. So I asked Pastor Blige, so we were going over there, Cole Avenue, to say. And I said, we didn't have a lot of men in the choir, but we had a lot of ladies. And I said, can you sing with us? He said, but I don't know the song. I said, don't matter, just open your mouth. Nobody would never know that you didn't know the song. But he stopped, then later, he wound up to be my vice president in the choir. And my topic is today, in the race.
All right.
My co-servant, I'm in it to the end. He's in the race, and he's in it to the end. And as he stayed in the house of God, and he stayed in the choir for a while, you'll get my point. He didn't stay there. Later on, Evangelist Maxwell was the pastor. She made him her assistant pastor.
Okay.
He's moving in the race. You'll get where I'm coming from. And he stayed there. You heard many times he said he learned a lot from her. Amen. He's in the race.
Well,
he's moving up.
All right.
Later on, he wind up being a bishop.
All right.
He's moving up.
All right.
He's staying in the race.
All right.
He's staying humble before God.
Yeah.
And God kept moving him up. Amen. Later on in this race, he became the pastor of the church.
Thank you, Lord.
Doesn't matter how he got there, but he got there.
Thank you, Lord.
He's moving up. In the race. But he stayed humble before the Lord. And later on in life, there's more to it, but we ain't going there.
Yes.
The late Apostle William Brown. We were there.
Oh, yeah.
We were there with the late Apostle William Brown, ordained him and Apostle Allen the apostle.
Yes.
And you know, I know some things I heard. They didn't think he was qualified. Because I heard one say, why he not ordaining him as an apostle? I've been here for years. He's moving up in the race. But you know what? I believe the late Pastor William Brown saw something in him. That's why, he, like he said before, people don't know. Him and Pastor Allen and him were the last two that was ordained on the Salvation Deliverance Ministry as apostle. And we were there at the time when this thing took place. I said, but this has to be God. Only God could do these things. But one thing about it, you have to love and appreciate it, you do, you don't. He stayed in the race. He went through many things. We were there when he got married to First Lady Blige. We were there when he lost First Lady Blige. When she got sick, we were there. We prayed. We were support to Pastor Blige. The Bible said, give honor where honor is due. All right. We give honor. It's not a feeling. It's a celebration. Yeah. Only God can do this. God had to be in his life. And what I like about it, he's still in the race. And he's in it to the end. Oh, Pastor Blodgett, don't mean that you're not going to go through some things in your life. He went through things when he lost his loved one. And it hurt him. We are healed. But one thing I heard, he said that Evangelist Blodgett already said to him, don't let me stop you from doing what God called to do. I said, he kept on staying in the race. I said, he didn't give up. I said, he may have some trials and tribulations. I heard him say a few times, people talked about it. But he didn't let that stop to take him out of that race. He stayed there in that race. Are you going to stay humble? Can I tell you something? Don't worry about what people say. All God wants you to do is that race. Stay like that. I heard him when he said, he fasted for 40 days at the boat. He fasted, he prayed. And only God could bring him through this for 39 years. We know people that been in it. We've seen people go. He's seen people stay, but he stayed in the race. I said he's still in the race. You have to love him. You have to kind of understand him. He said someday, even after, what did he say? Well, I'm honest about it. But you one thing about it, you have to read between the lines to get an understanding what he's talking about. But he teaches us to love one another. He teaches us to report one another. You know, he's not like others. Us Salvation Delivered Marmon Avenue, he's been all over. He support others. He loves you. He loves me. But can I tell you something? He longs to God. He's God's servant. He just limits us just a little time. God is his church. God is his church. I always said one thing. People may not like the truth, but that's all right. You have to. If you don't like his teaching or ministry, I feel like this. You can get me later. People don't have to listen. They don't have to be here. Am I right?
That's right.
But I thank God for one thing. I heard the sister say, he needs business with God. In my building, there's two young men. And they the Spanish, or Dominican, well, anyway, they went to prison and they saw me outside. You may be seated. I want you to listen to this. And one of them came to me. He said, "Hey, Mama, is the pastor still there?" I said, "He's still there." He said, "Tell him I'm back." He said, "I spent 3 years in prison." And he asked about this man, because this man put something in. He never forgot what he told him. And when he came home, he said, "Tell the pastor, I got married. I got a job, Sister Bodie, and my wife is expecting our baby." And when he said, "I hope to see him to let him know I have turned my life around." Just a few words that he said. It may be not, we may not reach everybody in the neighborhood, but he reached some. And there's another young man. He know he was in prison too. And he said, "How's the pastor? He's still there, Monique." I said, "He's still there." He said, "Tell him I said hi. I hope to see him to let him know I'm out of prison." His sister lived in my building. And I saw him, and I said, "Did you get this chance to see the pastor?" He said, "Yes. I just wanted to let him know I turned my life around." And he said, "I got a job now." You hear Ella Curtis? He said, "A good job." But it don't take but one little word to encourage somebody. We may not reach everybody in the neighborhood, but he let his light shine and he's making a difference in those young men's life. We appreciate Pastor Biden over here. I do. I was going through something, as some say, and I, when he blessed me, he said something to me, I almost passed out. I won't say what he said, what he did. But I thank God. You're not going to agree with everything he said, but agree with what the word said. He teaches us to love one another. He don't want us to be fighting over him. 39 years is a long time for him, because I know someone been in ministry for 60 years. It had not been easy for him. We were here when he came, and we are still here. As Sister Monique said, she was just a little girl. There are different generations in the church. Ella Bethune, me, Sister Savage, and others was here. Sister Bob, different Afro Bob, and all the Jane, Lily, all of them, Lisa, all of us was here, raised up in the church. And a lot of us went away, some gone home to be with the Lord, but we are still here. And what did the Lord do? He turned it around. He added another crop here and another generation. But he's in the race. He's in the race and he's not giving up. The Lord brought him from a mighty long way. And I'm quite sure he had some crying nights. I'm quite sure that he had some tears to shed. When he looked around, when he was married to his love of his life, and she wasn't there, as he always said, she was a big encouragement to him. She never stepped in his way. He told her, "Go ahead, go ahead." 39 years in the ministry. We've been out to a lot of churches. I've seen him do things. He'll turn around and leave the whole offering there and then take a dime. He said, I didn't come to take, but I come to be a blessing. We've seen that. I remember one year that I'm coming in, she's going to get, we don't want to pull on. We went out, Sister Bode, 18 times in 1 year. He read the people. Oh, God, we read some places you wouldn't believe. And he always took part in the church, but he took the choir and the musician. And I remember one time, we went to Connecticut. I don't know where we was, but it was so deep down in Connecticut. Oh, my God. But I remember, like the sister said, Pastor Biden, swear to God, he don't change for you or me and no one else. What I like about him, he said, I'm not changing. Doesn't matter what you do in your church. But over here, we are going by the word of God. If it ain't in the word, then it ain't so. So while we was at that church, I never would got it. We had fire. And I was thinking about it on this week. I thought about the evangelist Blyden. And he preached. He left the orphan there. His name was Pastor Robinson. And his wife the same. And yes, praise be to God. So he said, oh, all right, now the service. We're going to have our praise dance. Pastor Robinson, you know Pastor. He said, come on, let's go home. And he said, come on, y'all, let's go home. We thought we were going to eat.
If they do, you tell them we don't do that over here.
He may not preach like others. All right. Each and one of y'all are ministers there. He used each one in a different way. What we get, what's good for me, may not be good for Minister Mike.
Do you get where I'm coming from? I accept the word. That's for me. If a rebuke, I cry and take it. And they don't like it. When I find myself in the fault, I accept the word. But 39 years is a long time for him. But he didn't give up. And we thank God for those that came before him. Some that gone on be with God. But today we honor Apostle Louis Blyden. We honor him. We give him praise. So he stayed in the race. And the Spirit of the Lord said, you're in it to the end. To the end. You don't give up. You're going to have trials and tribulations sometimes. But God is there. Because he told us he'll never leave him.
That's right.
We are in this race. It's not how much, you know, something out real mean right now.
Yeah, I could have run before, but I can't to now.
So, but one thing, Sister Matt Bain, I'm still in the race. I'm still in the race. That's all that matters. If you don't get him up, you know, in a natural race, I know some about that too. And some can outrun others, right, Minister Mike? But one thing about it, you're still in the race. It doesn't matter how much do you get me? That's what Apostle Louis Barton is going to take to do. He's going to stay right there until the end. And you right here, we're going to go along with him. We're going to pray for him. We're going to lift him up. We're going to give him the glory. Hey, hey, come on and shout hallelujah. I thank God for a church. I thank God for a pastor. I thank God for a friend. I thank God for them ain't my friend. But I'm in the race. Because I'm on it. I'm on it. We thank God. We thank God for the new calling. If they don't know it, but I come to tell you, if you call him, he'll be right there. If you need it, he'll be there. But what, you know, if you need a dime or 50 cents, I'm just saying that, but he'll be right there for you. He's there. I'm a witness. I'm a witness. When I lost my mother, he said to the telegram, they read it in the church. I thank God for being in the race. He's in the race. He's going to go through changes. Yes, he will. Because the devil don't want him to stay in the race. But you in the race, Pastor Baja. Stay in the race. You're in it until the end. I like Pastor Paul said, I kept the faith. Keep the faith. Hold out. Sometimes he may don't feel well in the body. But he's always here. God gave him help to help him along when he don't feel good. We're his supporter. We're his prayer. We hold him up that the Lord would keep him. And we thank God that he's still in the race. And you're in it until the end. Don't give up. Don't give up. Stay in the race, Pastor Bajan. You're not alone. You're not alone. God is with you. Give the Lord a hand, praise. We didn't come so much to preach, but we came to give honor where your honors is due. And it's due to, this is his time. And we're here to support and be a blessing to him. Pray for me. We're not silent. We're a shout, but we're a shout after it all.